Hello, everyone. Happy Wednesday. My name is Michael Woodside. I'm an animator, and I want to teach you how to draw some characters. So today we're going to be learning how to draw Grumpy. A lot of people have been asking to draw humans, and this is our first human. He's a little cartoony. He's a little chunky in the face areas. A lot of different masses that we're going to be messing around with. So he's not a realistic human, but he's a lot of fun to draw. So I'm looking forward to that. Most people have been asking for some dwarfs to draw. And I think Grumpy is a fun one to draw because he, out of all the dwarfs, has the biggest progression, character progression. So, for those of you that are new, you might be wondering who is this for? Maybe you think you don't draw or you can't draw. It's okay. We're going to learn how to draw step by step. And I usually teach by simple shapes and line by line. And it takes about an hour to go through the whole drawing. So, I really think you'll have enough time to figure it out. Most people think that they don't know what they're doing, and then at the end they're like, I can't believe I drew that. So that's fun to see. I think you can do it too. We're all learning how to draw these characters together, and speaking of learning, because we're learning, you might get frustrated halfway through and think you want to throw it away and give up, but you don't. I promise you, even professional artists will think that they want to give up halfway through a drawing, but if you power through, you've learned a lot by the end of the drawing, and then you can go back kind of redo it a couple times and figure out how to draw these characters. I've drawn Grumpy a bunch preparing for this, and so if my drawing looks different than yours, it's just because I've practiced a little bit more, but you can practice just as much as I did. As for supplies, I'm going to be using just two pencils today and a sheet of paper. First pencil for underdrawing is this Tuscan Red, it's called, and then I'm also going to be using my darker pencil. It's the same pencil that I've been using before, it's just a different hardness. So try that one out. Oops, up here. There we go. You can see it. That is supplies. Very easy. Anyone can follow along. You can draw with pencils or with crayons or markers. It really doesn't need to be fancy art supplies. Somebody was asking recently what kind of art supplies were needed in order to do a good drawing. What kind of pencils should they get? And it really doesn't matter. I've seen a lot of really good drawings come through on Instagram. From the Drawing with Woodsy hashtag, where people just use like number two pencils that you would use in school. So you can do anything with any tool, and don't let that stand in your way. So, because of the time that we're in, I like to always clean my hands before we start drawing. So, I'm going to do that now. That I think is a useful practice, not just in the time that we're in now where people are cleaning up, but just because also our art supplies are gross. We're holding them all the time, and I feel like people chew on their pencils and it can get gross. So wash your hands before you start working. I think that's all the lead up. It's Wednesday. It's halfway through the week. I feel like it's a good time to draw Grumpy. Let's do that. So bring this over here. See at the top, that's the hashtag that we use if you want to share your work online, and that way I can find it and I can share it. You can also tag me in your stories. That's a good way to do it too if you post on Instagram. And then I can share it on mine, and people who follow me will click through my stories at the end of the day and see all the different characters as drawn by everyone. So let's start with some music. So if you've done this before, you know what we do at the beginning, which is a lot of circles. Let me move this over here so you can see better. So I put circles over in the top left side just to warm up my arm. Got a lot of music today from Snow White, from the score. It's got a lot of really classic sounding character, so ooh, I do need to warm up. So the reason I'm warming up with circles is because Grumpy has a lot of really round shapes, and I want to make sure that I'm capturing that in my art. So what I'm doing right now is just teaching my arm through muscle memory how to make these circular shapes, and hopefully as we progress mine will be more consistent. If I move with just my hand, kind of you see that the circle gets these weird corners in it, and if I move with my wrist it's a little more, it's harder to hold the pencil that way. So if you watch, I'm moving my whole arm around, and that gives me more control over the shape. So that's why I do it the way that I do it. And in order to do your final drawing, you might be wondering about how sloppy this looks. I take my darker pencil and then I just can outline the ones that I want to keep.
If you'd seen this class before, you know that once we do that, then that sort of helps the other, in this case, Tuscan red lines disappear, but the maroon lines go away, and really all you see is these. A little shady. So, like I said, for Grumpy, we're actually gonna leave a little bit of room at the top and a little more room on the bottom. Because when we draw Grumpy, we're gonna draw his head, a little bit of his hat, and then he has a pretty long beard. So, I wanna make sure that we leave room for that. So, let's go ahead and do this circle. You see, when I draw a circle, it's never just like, I never do it just one time and then I'm done. It's really kind of a feathery, scratchy circle as I figure out the shapes. Grumpy has this great frown too, so we're gonna be making sure that we get that in there. A lot of weird shapes today, so be sure to follow closely because it can get a little tricky. Okay, so like normal, our circle head is a sphere to indicate which way we think the character might be looking. And I made this ping pong ball that sort of tells us what we want to see from the character's head angle. So Grumpy is actually going to be turned this direction, where this line is almost flat, and then this line is turned facing over here, because he's going to be looking to the left side of our page. So that's what we're going to be trying to draw today. So let's go ahead and start with this line here. This is the front of the circle. We can imagine that this might go around to the other side here. We're just going to see it this side. And then the horizontal line is almost flat. So I'm just going to draw that this way. A little darker than I normally would, just to make sure that you can see it in the video. You guys' Pooh drawings from yesterday were adorable. He's a really fun character, and I never have drawn him before. Even Grumpy I've never really drew before, so I guess I have some cool suggestions that are helping me learn how to draw. There isn't really a way to draw these characters like one way. There's a bunch of different techniques to get you there. So my philosophy is just to try to find the most consistent and universal shapes that we can use to bring us to the same drawing. That a little bit. So the first thing that we're gonna do outside of the head is gonna be his nose. Grumpy has this great big nose, so the way that I think about the nose is sort of like a D, so I'm going to show you what the letter, capital letter D, if I were to turn it this way. So we're just drawing that as a starting indicator. Now Grumpy really doesn't have any corners in his design, so we don't want to keep this corner here, so I'm going to start rounding it out here. And then bring it down all the way, rounding it out here. So if you analyze the shape after I drew it, it's about to the bottom of the circle here. And then he's got this nostril that arcs back around. I told you it's a weird shape. We're gonna get through it. Big nostril. So I don't know if I said it yet, but Grumpy is my favorite dwarf because he is the one that goes through the biggest change. He doesn't want to meet Snow White when we see her. He doesn't want to get to know her at all after we know her. He hates that he has to wash his hands like I know a lot of you do. He really comes around by the end and becomes a sweetheart. So I gave him this little bump here too because it gives him some, it's as if this little nostril is pushing even more on the the fat of the nose and creating a little divot there. So that's what that guy is. I'll sharpen again. Big nose. Okay, so I'm gonna put the eyes in next. The eyes are ovals that go on either side of the center line here, and they are pretty big, so they're not huge. He's got a lot of space in the back of his head, so we're not gonna go too wide with it. They're just kind of tall. And I'll draw this one first. It's gonna be kind of right along the end over here. We're gonna do this kind of lightly because the eyebrows are gonna cut into it. I'm doing it a little darker here so that you can see it in the video. Let's do this one here. And this is probably helpful for me to turn it this way so that you can see it. So before we move on, we have to make him look grumpy. He's grumpy. We can't just sit here and make him have these big wide open eyes. So I'm going to show you where the eyebrows go. They are crazy shapes. So this top eyebrow, think of it like it's going to be an upside down J. It starts outside of the head and then comes in and connects here with the top of the eye. See how that these two lines sort of meet? Like a backwards upside MJ. Crazy weird shape. You can do it. We've done a bunch of these kinds of shapes before. But this brow is different. So if we were to see Grumpy from the front right now, this eyebrow would be like this. But we're going to do this eyebrow like this. So he's got a little bit of a slant in his eyes. So what that looks like from this angle, if you think of it, it's like the letter S got stretched out and then started rolling over this way a little bit. So it's a lot, it's like this. Does that make sense?
Yeah, Michael, that makes perfect sense.
Oh, thanks everybody. It's good to hear from you. So I'm gonna start that here in the middle. Arc it back up and then up again. A lot of weird shapes, but almost immediately starts to feel more like Grumpy like that. So there's a thickness to it that I'm just going to start indicating by going back up where we started and then turning to the right earlier. That kind of same thing here, just so we're going to color that in black eventually. So let's just finish off the left side of the head here. I'm going to give him his cheek, which is going to start right about the middle of the eye here. Just going to make a little round line that goes out this way, and it just disappears behind the nose. And then from where that meets the circle, we're going to connect it into the eyebrow to give him these really meaty eyebrows that we can feel like we can just grab. You shouldn't. Never grab someone's eyebrows. I don't know if anyone has ever said that before, but it's an important lesson. Don't grab anyone's eyebrows. Weird. Okay, so I'm going to just start arcing it up. And then it's going to come right back to the circle. Like that. Give me a second to catch up because these shapes are strange. Just going back and making the nostril a little bigger. So there are some perfectionists that become artists, and I just want to talk to them real quick. If you're not a perfectionist, you know you can tune out. But for most of us, we're perfectionists, and we really want it to be a perfect drawing. And it rarely will be, especially the first time you draw something, you learn from it. So changing your drawing and shaping it, that's okay. That shows that you're thinking while you're drawing, and that's actually a good thing. So you don't want to just kind of draw on autopilot. You really want to be examining and always checking everything against another part, especially when a drawing is as strange and as complicated as this, but I have a feeling you guys are doing okay. I'm looking forward to seeing what Grumpy looks like. The cool thing with Grumpy is that he's got all kinds of meat on his face, so if it shifts around, it still kind of looks like him because he's just really chunky in the face. Like I'm becoming. So let's go ahead and give him his cheek. His cheek is the weirdest shape that we probably have ever drawn. So I'm just going to start doing it here. And I'm going to draw through the nose because it's a big shape that connects around. So I'm going to bring it up this way. It's an arc that connects into the nose. It goes through the eye, this part right there. And then it's going to eventually, this is all behind the nose, but I just draw it so I know where it is. Wraps around, comes back out this way. And it has this weird bend in it. You'll see why in a minute. And then I just darken this part here so it connects into that. Weirdest shape we've ever drawn. I'm going to darken the parts that we're going to keep so that I remember for later not to do this part. Fun fact, this person singing is not the voice of Grumpy. I don't know if you knew that. Okay, so now that we have the cheek in there, I want to draw where the mouth is. The mouth is actually pretty similar to this shape because they're connected. So I'm going to start right below the circle. And bring it up. But it's not going to go all the way up. It's going to come right back down and kind of sit in this pocket here. And this part over here, I make a little thicker. This drawing is based off of, I believe it's a Freddie Moore animation. Freddie Moore was this amazing animator. Did a lot of really great stuff with Mickey and Pluto. One of Walt's original animators, all the way back. So he did a lot of work to make the characters feel really fleshy and have a lot of personality in their shapes. So even to the current design at Disney, we owe a lot to him. So let's go ahead and finish off the bottom of the face. He's got a big bottom lip, so I'm just thinking this mouth connects up here, the lip goes down here. It's another arc line. So when I do the lip, I'm making it a little fatter at the bottom, because it'll feel like it's bigger here than here. I'm telling you, these are weird shapes, right? I hear you. Let's bring that back a little bit, and then give them a little line similar to this nose line. That just means that there's some things bunching down here. And let's do the chin. Just a little arc line like that. Okay, this is almost it for the weird shapes. We're gonna move back into some more familiar shapes soon. There's just one big weird shape left to go, and that's his cheek. So all of these shapes have kind of come up and then down and back around. So this is just how all of those shapes meet down at the very end. So we're going to start, it's going to be in front of the chin, right here. And then we're going to bring it around. It's going to meet all the way back up here. Weird shape. It could be now. It might be now that you're thinking, I'm going to throw mine away. Don't do it. Don't do it. I promise. It's going to be a cool, it's going to be a weird looking drawing at the end. Even mine probably, but it's still a step towards learning how to draw grumpy. So just got to practice these weird shapes and take it slow. That's all the Snow White music I have, so we're going to do some more from different movies. Okay, so let's just do a line that we've already done, because I could use a little breather. So we already have the top of the circle. I'm just going to draw the top of the circle as it meets this eyebrow meet. Draw it up. Now that we have this, we're going to draw the brim of the hat, and that's going to go from here down to here, but it's not a straight line, like a little S curve, so it has this kind of feel to it. So you can practice this line over here on this side. It starts going up a little bit and then drops and then comes back like that. It starts here, down, and connects into the cheek. That can stick out a little bit too, a little past, because it overlaps. And those of you who've done this before know what overlap means. Overlap is when something is in front of another thing, and you just draw that by making the front one a little darker. I'm gonna give him little sideburns, the hair kind of poking out here, and it's just, think about the letter W, but the tops of the W just connect into this line here. So I'm going to do that right here. Like that. Okay, let's do the part of the hat here. There's like a big brim. It's pretty thick, so it's similar to this eyebrow, how it comes out. We're going to have an arc line just come over and then back around here. So that's the front of the hat. And then just one more little mountain right there. Little bump. It's all the same kind of thing as these masses are kind of bunching together, they kind of form these rounded shapes. So it's a lot of the same principles that are being applied to the whole character. Okay, now, in order to get the back of the hat, we actually need to go to the beard. So, strange, but let's do it. We're gonna start just forward of where the bottom lip connects, right about here on the nose. And then I'm just gonna draw a line that's arced like that. See that? So that's the front of the beard. It's going to have a little hairs coming off of it. And then the back of the beard, we're going to start right about where the cheek starts turning back into the hat. You're going to start out and then arc it over to the end of the beard. So I'm just drawing these little lines that come off of the shape that we built, and that shows where the hairs are. So he's got some hairs back here. These don't really need to be anything specific. Don't go too detailed with it because he doesn't have a ton of detail. You just pick a couple of places to have the lines come off, and then it kind of gives you the illusion of hair, so you don't have to draw every individual hair, which would be crazy time consuming. Okay, so now to get to the back of the hat, we needed to build off of the beard, so that's why we started with that here. So thinking about this shape, wrapping around, I'm just gonna bring it here. So this is still part of the hat. Think about it as the back brim of the hat, and the gravity is kind of pushing it down against the head. So we're gonna give it a little bump and then build off just a little rounded line here. It's kind of where all of his hair is collecting in the back of his head. Okay, so we have to draw the back of the hat, and we need to get the back of the hat to go somewhere. So actually, strangely, I'm gonna start with where it ends up. That way we have a goal, and then we can go back to where we were gonna start from and then end up at our goal. So from the bottom of the beard, I'm just gonna draw a big letter U. And that U is just like this. And that's gonna be the tip of the hat. So from right about, if you think about where this cheek is here, just maybe go straight down. It's got a long, long hat. So a big letter U that goes out this far. And this, you can just kind of go straight up for a bit. Do that lightly, because we're going to bring the hat into it. So to do the very back of the hat, top and back, that's a J. That's a J shape right there. So we started with a U and turned it into a J. So we're gonna go a little almost flat and then round it out and just meet up with that line. Weird shapes. So for everyone asking to draw humans have a lot of difficulty when we're drawing them. So I kind of wanted to ramp into doing humans with something a little more forgiving. It's interesting. One of the hardest things to animate is a character walking in a believable way, because we see people walking all the time. And so if it doesn't look right or it doesn't feel right, we know kind of immediately that it's not working. And because everyone is kind of an expert at watching somebody walk. If we're animating, a character being pushed around by the ocean like Moana, that feels like it's not as familiar of an action, so it gives the animator a little more freedom to do something. Similarly, when you're designing a human or drawing a human, we look at people all day, and so if the proportions look weird, it's because we're always looking at people. So just wanted to start with maybe a little more cartoony of a person, and then we can eventually maybe do more complex. But I do want this class to be fun, and sometimes drawing people is more difficult than it is fun. Recently though, if you wanted to see how one of my friends at work draws a person, Wayne Unton is the animation supervisor for Elsa. And just yesterday, I believe, they put up a video of him teaching you how to draw Elsa on the Disney Animation Instagram and Twitter and YouTube. So he's great and kind of goes through a lot of really helpful step-by-steps that I recommend for everybody. Wayne Unton teaches Elsa. Check that out. We have a couple more lines to do before we go into the eyes, finishing those off. Similar to all these little bumps that we have here, we're going to give one to the eyeball, but just not connected. It's just going to be like a little line there, kind of like if you think about an eyeball, if you squint, kind of has those lines that come out of the side of it. Call it crow's feet. So that's what he's got here. And then one last little, because because he's got this meaty eyebrow on this side, we give him this line over here to show that this eyebrow also has that kind of mass. Lastly, we want to give him his eyeballs. So we're going to have him looking over here. So I just give him an arced line. I lightly color that in just to make sure that it feels like they're both looking in the same direction. Because you'd be surprised how many, I don't know if you guys deal with this, but how many times my drawings look like they're not looking at the same spot. Cheek too big, so that's fine. I kind of want to make the nose even bigger on mine. You don't have to do that, but luckily his nose is actually pretty close to this color, so I'm just going to color it in with that once we do the outlines. Okay, let's try doing some outlines. So I'm using, it's a similar pencil to the ones I've used before, but it is just different enough. Let's see if it still works. I'm gonna double check the camera, make sure you can see it well. It's kind of a little shinier, so we'll do the same pencil we've been using. Everyone who takes this class multiple times knows that I am a right-handed person. And so because of that, I move my arm across the page from left to right. And I want to draw so that I don't smudge the page. So while I'm doing the harder outlines, I'm working left to right. And there's things you can do to help mitigate some smudging that might happen, so I might have to do that, but meantime, I recommend that. If you are lefty, then you can start on the right side of your page and move the other direction. But this works for me. One of the cool things about working at a place like Disney is that these characters might come back around. I don't know if anyone saw Wreck-It Ralph 2, but Grumpy is in Wreck-It Ralph 2 for a minute when they go to the Oh My Disney site. He's like in a green room backstage, says something like, "Cast members only." But it's cool that you get a chance to bring them back sometimes. Do that if you work on the theme park rides or any kind of special project. I love drawing to music because it makes you feel like something special is happening. I think music is a gift for us, especially now, this time. We always have music on in the house. Belle, it's me. She moves his hair.
It is you.
So lip. Doing the drawing at a different time today because we have people doing construction next door. About to start recording earlier today, and they were hammering and screaming, so wasn't a great time to do this. A little later than normal, but nice. Do the front of the beard here. Since I already have the foundational structure, I kind of, if I can, I like doing the beard with faster strokes. It makes it feel a little lighter. Start digging to the beat. Don't know why. Okay. Now, I'm just going to work out the J that we had earlier. So we talked before about the idea of tapering a line. And tapering just means it's thin and then thick and then thin again. And I want to try that here on the bottom of the hat because I want it to be thick where it's heaviest. Then it gets thin here, where it's being stretched down by the weight. One of the most inspiring things for me from the history of Snow White is that it, when it was being made, nobody in the world thought it was worth being made. Because cartoons at the time were just little short things that would happen before quote-unquote real movies would play. And Walt Disney was spending a ton of money trying to get this thing finished because they were sort of inventing it as they went along. And it had never been done like this before. And so they one day had to screen it for the banks and, you know, around town. I don't know if they said this yet. It was called Walt's Folly. Mistake. And so they had to screen it for the banks to figure out if they could get a little bit more money to finish it. There was already a lot of bad press about the film. So Walt was super nervous, obviously, trying to screen the film. So they screened what they had in progress for the guy, and then the banker just sort of left after the movie and just was walking out, and Walt chased after him and said, what do you think? And the banker was like, it's great. Just finish it. We can have whatever you need. I'm glad that he did say that because everything changed after Snow White came out. This is where you double check and make sure that you got all the lines. Cool. So I'm going to start coloring in some of those areas that we talked about. I'm going to color in the nose and the hat. They're both kind of a similar color. The hat's darker, so I'm going to do a little less pressure on the nose and then more pressure on the hat. So I'm just going to the side of my pencil so I can cover more ground more quickly. Funny thinking about the Snow White thing, because for as long as most of us have been alive, Snow White has been inevitable, right? It's just been, but it almost wasn't. I'll shade in a little bit, give it some depth. Did forget a line. I forgot this one. See? More red, it would look like Sneezy. I'll leave it like that. Okay, so the hat again is a little darker, so I'm going to color it in again from here. Sometimes darker doesn't mean pressing down more the whole time, it could just mean you just go over it again in layers. So while it might be boring to watch, I think we're going to try to do that today. See how I'm going over it again, just getting a little darker. Trying to go over it again in the same direction that I went over it the first time, so that I'm not changing the path of the pencil. It feels the same. Just getting a little darker in these areas. Shadow here. So hopefully you can see as you're coloring things in that the construction lines, as we're learning, kind of get out of the way, right? And then we just focus on the darker lines that we're hoping people see. And I think that is the same for as you're practicing. The more you practice, the more that the construction will fade away and it'll just start to feel natural. Because when animators are animating, they draw really quickly. But the reason they do that is because they have drawn the characters thousands of times. So they have a lot of practice. So it's impressive that they can draw quickly, the 2D animators. But I think what I'm always impressed by is their discipline and their diligence to learn how to do it, because everybody struggles with drawing, everybody. So even the best artist in your house right now, who's always got the best drawing, they struggle too. They just don't tell you about it. They're practicing. So everybody is trying to get better. And I think that's a smart thing for us to do during this time, is to take some time to do something creative and fulfilling. Drawing should be fun, especially now. I'm gonna go a little lighter up here at the top, because this is probably getting the most light, right? Because it's, let's say the sun is up there, or a candle or something that's lighting the room. So I'm gonna give him some red cheeks too. I'm gonna use just the same pencil. I'm gonna do that just by going really, really, really lightly over where the cheeks are. Probably so lightly that you can't tell on the video, but do the same thing over here. I've heard it described as just kissing the page, just really lightly. There's a shadow point, so I'm gonna color that in a little darker down here. And the last thing I want to do is just shade the beard a little differently. So just, remember how with Kua yesterday we were doing these strokes here and then darker ones in between? It's the same idea, just going really, really lightly, because it's a really light beard then. Same thing here. I don't want to go too detailed with the shading here, because then it just starts to look too realistic, but little bits of shade here help kind of give it some character. Well, with that, and with that music, I think it's time for us to sign our drawings. So I'm going to sign mine down here in the bottom corner. And there we go. That's Grumpy. Let's switch back over to our station.
Cool. I'm sure you can see me. That is a difficult character to draw. So if you had a hard time with that, you are not alone. I practiced a lot to get there. I still probably could practice more. So those are the basic shapes to get started with. And then you can keep building off of it and building off of it. And the last thing I want is for when people are drawing Grumpy to be grumpy. So hopefully you had a good time. Don't forget that now that we're done drawing, we still want to clean our hands. You can't see it, but the sides of my hands are covered in pencil. So I want to make sure that I clean off a little bit. If you didn't sign your drawing yet, be sure to sign it. Take a picture of it and then post it online using Drawing with Woodsy, because I'd love to see how it turned out. And then we'll see you tomorrow. And remember, just because we're separated doesn't mean we need to be alone. So let's do this again tomorrow, okay? Bye now.